Dude, the hell are you doing?
What?
Forgot a mask.
Hi, I'm Lila Wendrick. Welcome to Lila's Craft Corner. Are you excited for Thanksgiving? I'm not. I have a very bad relationship with my family. Would you like to do a turkey craft now, please? For this craft, you're going to need red, yellow, orange, and brown pieces of construction paper. You could also have a clothesline. I recommend it. And maybe, if you're feeling silly, some googly eyes. Let's get started. You're going to tear it up. These are going to be your turkey's feathers. Do you want your turkey to be huge or small? I want my turkey big. Did anybody ever let you craft? You should be able to craft. Lila's Craft Corner Progress Report! Ah! This is really coming together. Yes!
Yay!
I think I'm done with my feathers. I'm so happy with them. Now it is time to insert the clothespin. It looks perfect. Now I will add googly eyes and a nose. How many hours of sleep do you get a night? Turkey time. This is my turkey, Brandon. He is so happy you're here. And for me and Brandon, a happy Thanksgiving.
Yeah, hello everyone. Welcome back to the bi-weekly meeting to plan, coordinate, and conduct evil activities. During these unprecedented times, the doing of evil is more important now than ever, and your commitment to this group is greatly appreciated. You've heard the speech before, but what's evil without the formalities? Okay, I guess we'll get started with the update section. Does anyone have any updates?
Well, I
do.
Go ahead.
No, please go. I interrupted you.
Thank you. But recently I derailed the PPA railway system.
Outstanding, although a bit concerning that you show no regard for human life. Remind me to talk to you about that when we're done here.
I got my team to drop cinder blocks in the passing motorcade of Parliament.
See, that's what we're looking for. Something to really stick it to the man without actually hurting anyone in the process.
An onlooker died.
Well, you did your best. Is it my turn? All right. Friends, colleagues, fellow evildoers, I have a plan that capsizes everything we thought we knew about government, politics, and economics. And if executed, will set us on track to rule the world in just 60 days. No one can stop us now. So the plan goes like this. James Bond!
That's right.
Well, it was one hell of an entrance, Bond. But do you really think I wasn't expecting you? I don't even have to leave my house for this coup! Guards! Seize him!
What the hell?
Yeah. Good luck getting out of that one, Bond.
Yes. Now, where were we? He looks very funny in there. Ha!
You know, he does. All right. Meeting adjourned. Let's mess with Bond's prison.
Mark my words, when this pandemic is over, I will find each of you and make you pay for these crimes.
Mark my words, Bond. I will frame your head and put it in my living room!
No!
Oh, look at our little fancy boy there.
Oh, you got some mustache on your ears. Glued on.
I didn't glue it on. Get this off of me!
Yeah, all right. That was enough fun. Time to kill him.
What are you going to do, Professor?
Something I should have done a long time ago.
No.
All right, where were we? Oh, yes. So the plan goes like this.
Uh-oh, get off the phone. There's a guy behind you.
Hello, it's Lazarus. How have I been doing? I've been doing great, actually. I just finished my prototype, one-man show, special, lifetime work, poems from a photo man inside the mind, by Lazarus Howell, me. It's out there. Go watch it. Can watch it. I'm fine. It's on my YouTube channel, guys. So it's on there forever, which means you have no excuse to not watch it. I'm gonna spend the rest of my 2 minutes talking about this show because not enough people came to my premiere. So eat my ass. So what I've done is I've taken my 1 hour long baby and I've condensed it to a minute and a half. Like you can shorten my genius. Takes place in the West. Pow, pow, and I'm depressed. Four-way stand-up of Kanye West, capitalism, and a literal horse. Sex, 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 and I'm depressed. I'm talking to a dildo. Pah, I'm dead. Have you seen my scaly fanfiction? I put it right next to my Madonna whore complex. MCR card. They say I'm depressed. Midlife crisis break. I get some bangs. And now for the vlog. The weather is depressed. I read my co-star and said I was a mess. My titties were out and drunk and depressed. I took drugs more. I should have took less. I'm acting like a joker because I'm fucking depressed. And now for my Oscar performance. I am down. I am despair. I am depressed. I look at the stars, the best, the quest and the test, the ass and the breast. I look back at my mess, and I take it close to my chest, because even you knew I was depressed. Thank you. Now go out and watch my one-man show. Or eat my depressed ass, you bitch.
Good evening. Now that Joe Biden has finally won the 2020 election, it seems like for once, things actually might be all right. However, the threat of the Proud Boys and QAnon is something in the back of the minds of many Americans. Today, me and my team have been able to expose one of these piece of shit rat bastards right before your very eyes. I'm Jack Melcher, and this is To Catch a Proud Boy.
Going into this, I knew I couldn't do this alone. I had to assemble the dream team. I had to keep in mind of my resources, so I took my search to 4chan and Reddit. And I found what I was looking for. Four internet vigilantes of the most exceptional class. And here they are. Up first is up-and-coming SoundCloud rapper 32-ounce Hydro Flask.
Hey, what's going on? It's your boy 32. Anybody thirsty?
Up next is Instagram model Lucas DiGiorno.
It's not delivery. No. Lucas fucking DiGiorno.
Joining us is also the guy from Top 15s.
They said the blue wave was coming, and now it's here.
And last but not least, Trevor Dudisick.
Ah.
Now that I had my team, it was time to get to work. I called a meeting at our safe house in Chicago.
Gentlemen, now that we're all here, does anyone have any idea how we can take down a conservative superpower?
Gotta go big.
I say we pull an Archduke Franz Ferdinand, go after one of their leaders.
I agree. A classic tactic of guerrilla warfare.
That's great, but where do we find these guys?
Easy. Facebook.
So we began our search on Facebook, but there was one small problem. There were too damn many of them to choose from. So we went to the internet forums of OAN, and there was even more. And then we checked out Twitter.
Hi, Melch.
Yeah, what's up?
I think I found our guy.
A failed white GOP senator pretending to be a gay black man. Perfect. But how do we get this man from rural Pennsylvania to come out to our safe house in Chicago? Easy. Tell him you have a bunch of Trump ballots that weren't counted just lying around. No, like, it was really easy. He was there within a day. Little did he know, our decoy was waiting.
Where are the ballots? Right this way, Mr. Browning. AON is on.
Wait a minute. This is NBC!
So what are you doing here? The election's over, Mr. Browning.
No, the results have not been certified. Georgia is still counting.
That's not true. But what is you're our first guest on a new reoccurring segment to catch a Proud Boy.
What? What? No. No, fake news.
Would you like to explain those tweets?
No, my Twitter was hacked. Also fake news.
We got you.
What are you, thirsty? Thirsty for some justice?
It's fake news! It's fake news! It is fake news!
Hey, this isn't fake news. It's DiGiorno.
Guys, we need to talk about something.
What's wrong?
Jack, are you taking my clothing?
I am not a child. You disgust me! Good day!
Yeah, I've actually never done therapy before, but my friends say it can be like super beneficial, and I need a professional opinion, so here it goes.
Well, let me just let you know before we start, for full, honest, and transparent reasons, I do have a very spontaneous look.
It pops up out of nowhere, so when you're talking, just try not to get too distracted by it.
Okay, yeah, like no worries, none at all. I've just been feeling like super ungrounded lately.
Tell me about it, sister.
Yeah, just like Trump's presidency has really fucked my family over. Like my dad.
I know, but you know, I'm not really one to complain. I don't really want to complain right now because we're on your time, but I think that therapists need therapy.
Or at least like a good laugh every day. Like, come on, comedy arts, tell me a joke.
I feel like this. I feel like this is really inappropriate use of.
You hear that? What's that? I so think that is the sound of the massage train coming to pop the clubs up and let's get it going. Okay,
choo-choo!
I don't think.
Because you know what it is? It's okay. Kind of like, for me, it's like.
Okay, Raquel, you don't need a therapist because you are a therapist. And, you know, I've been told by a patient that I'm a very good therapist because I really prioritize comfortability.
Yeah, no, I can definitely see where that narrative would come from.
And you gotta know, I have this serious need for constant validation.
Is it constant? Because, like, you are in a session with a patient.
So why are you, as a patient, not trying to validate my expert opinion, huh? Okay, good. Because I need your opinion on something.
Oh.
We got that confidentiality agreement in place, right? Like, you don't have a big mouth.
No, like, I have one with you. But you do not have one with me.
Good, because I laundered money to start the practice. I'm a money launderer. I'm a laundering money scoundrel. That's what I am. I feel like a tool. You look confused.
Look, I think I should just go.
No,
I think I should go.
You don't need to go, because how was I going to be able to start the practice in the first place? This judgment, it needs to go. That needs to go, not you.
You built this shithole on illegal money?
Don't call it a shithole. The fairy lights weren't free.
Okay. But I'm like, can I get in trouble for this? Because, like, you, Raquel, you are definitely going to jail. But, like, I can't. I have depression, IPS, and, like my father,
he
grew an extra leg and we can't.
I know all of these things, and Raquel, you don't have to worry about it. You're not going to get in trouble. A little bit directly involved. A bit more. Wait, please, Susie, don't go. I haven't gone to talk about my IRAC experience yet.
Do I sit here? Okay.
All right, Miss Courtney. Now, just in your own words, please tell us what happened.
Well, I guess it started back in May. We were 3 months into the world falling apart, and I just needed something to occupy my spare time. you know, it felt like my life had this hole, and I wanted to fill it. I mean, it needed to be filled. And that's how I found him. And at first, you know, it was just something to do with my spare time, but then I stopped sleeping and eating, and I couldn't get my work done. I mean, it was intense. And I didn't think it could get any worse. And then it did. He started showing up in my daily life. Places that he shouldn't be. I mean, it was like he was haunting me. I was being haunted by Edward Cullen. That shiny, sparkly, pale-faced bastard. And I mean, he was everywhere. I would brush my teeth and he would be there. I would try to do my work and he would be there. I would try to go to sleep at night and he would fucking be there. I started acing BuzzFeed quizzes and like, I really didn't even have to try that hard. And I mean, it's not like he's a good person. He's manipulative. His brother's a fucking Confederate soldier and we're just supposed to be okay with that? I had to do something about it, and so I did. And I mean, it took a lot of guts. Like, it took literally everything I had left, but I did it. I murdered Edward Cullen. I murdered him with my bare hands.
And now that you've done that, how are you feeling?
Oh. I'm doing great. Never better, actually.
Morning, man.
Morning.
Hey, so, what's up with Trev?
I have no idea. He's been like that since I woke up.
What is he staring at?
No clue. Hasn't moved at all.
Creepy.
Could I get some orange juice? Go for it.
I'm Cup. You're probably wondering how I got here. Let me tell you, it's a long story. That's my dad, Red Solo Cup Sr. He taught me everything I know about being a cup. He says we're all uniquely crafted, and we each serve a special purpose.
You think we should say something to him? I mean, you can if you want to. I'm just a little bit too freaked out.
Oh, Jesus Christ! Save me, my child! Save me, my child!
Father, no! Don't leave me!
Well, I guess that's what we get for trying to look for roommates on Craigslist.
I know. I regret it. Did I tell you I caught him staring at me the other night?
What?
My son, I do not have much longer on this mortal plane, so listen to me quick. You are special. You are not like my other 26 sons. You have something deep within you that makes you Red Solo Cup 25. You must cherish and love yourself. You could go anywhere and do anything. I love you.
I love you too.
Yeah, like I woke up at 2 a.m. and he was just in my room staring at me.
What, did you say anything?
Yeah, I asked him about it. He chalked it up to sleepwalking.
Oh, bullshit.
Yeah, I know.
Was he doing anything?
No. He was just staring.
Another one gone, to the horror of the legged ones. He didn't stand a chance. He was nothing to them.
No. My father was a good cup. A special cup with wisdom.
Do you know how many corpses I've thrown to the dustpan? Tell me, little one, what made him your father?
He was above me in the stack.
Exactly. You are not unique. You are not special. You are expendable. You are disposable.
Well, I think one of us should say something.
Alright, well, that's all you, buddy.
Wait, why's it gotta be me?
Well, because I'm the one who had to deal with the sleepwalking.
Alright, okay, fine. Where's my drink?
Well, I guess you know how I got here. All my cup life, I've been a terrified of death, but I'm not scared of it right now. I'm only terrified because I'm alone. I guess I know why they call us Red Solo Cups.
Well, here goes nothing.
Hey, buddy, Are you doing all right?
The kitchen speaks to me.
What the fuck?
Hey Siri, can you read me my most recent text message?
My sex life said 0.00000% of all women reach orgasm during penile vaginal intercourse. Would you like to reply?
Absolutely not.
Oh, I was really excited because the store is going out of sale, so everything was on sale. No. And I got all kinds of cool ass shit for this project. Stickers. More stickers. More stickers. I got the sparkly board. So it was like two blocks from the store without hurting the poster board. And a water bottle fell out of my backpack and pew, right in the fucking middle, breaking it. I'm ready for a fight. So I guess, yeah, we will love the water bottle. That caused me so much despair by making it look pretty with stickers. I don't know. I like stickers. It is a cheap fucking thing to get at gift shops. Stickers, and I have, and you know, you get free stickers sometimes, and maybe I have too many stickers! They live in this bag. The previous footage was recorded of the painstaking efforts I went to decide on three stickers for my water bottle. I've been using the mic wrong too. Why is that flickering? No. No! What? Are you kidding me? This thing uses up that much fucking juice? My entire battery pack got zapped? Oh, fuck my life. God. I just thought I could hold myself together. Why? The common factor is really intense mommy issues. Oh my god, I'm such a fucking asshole.
Are you mourning a loss of a loved one? White lilies symbolize death and mourning, and we can make some out of some white construction paper and pipe cleaners.
All you have to do is trace your hand. I hate my hands. They make me uncomfortable. Cut out your hand now. Every day I wake up confused at about 3 a.m. I remember often that I will only find solace in the art that I produce. That art being crafts. And being here with you great teens. Tweens can join in, but make sure that they're safe. Now, you're going to want to glue the base of your pipe cleaner in the middle. If you want to make it look like you are having pollen in there for fun, you can cut off a little bit of yellow and stick it in there real nice. And now you're going to roll up your silly little fingers.
For you, it is a white lily, because I heard about that death you've experienced. Maybe yours looks a little different, because sometimes teens and tweens have smaller hands than me.
Stuart, it's 3 a.m. Are you okay? Stuart?
So the PS5 comes out in 2 days?
Yeah, 2 days.
Stuart's been acting really strange, to say the least.
And it's gonna be fine, because I have a pair of $1,000, and I'll be on the website early, and I'll be there before midnight, because I'll be able to get a PS5, and I'm gonna be able to play Miles Morales, because I already pre-ordered Miles Morales.
I don't know what's gonna happen if he doesn't get one.
Come on, 5 minutes, come on!
You got this.
Okay. Now. Come on. Nothing. Okay, no, it's fine. It's fine. It'll be fine. It'll go live. The Xbox launch didn't go live at launch either, so I'll just keep refreshing. I'll just sit here. I'll just refresh it. Got it!
Yay!
It's in my cart! I got one! Wait, damn it, come on!
What happened?
It's not taking my code. It says the code is wrong, but it isn't. Come on, you motherfucker!
Yeah, you tell him!
No! Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck
you. Hey, what's going on?
Fuck you. It took it out of my fucking cart! This website is a bastard, and... Looking back on it, it really wasn't worth staying up as late as I did that night. I just kept refreshing, checking different stores, and every time I thought I'd go to bed, I just thought, what if it goes back in stock again? And I'd just keep refreshing.
It's been 3-4 days since the launch. Still no PS5, obviously. But I do have this. I can't really do anything with it, but I have it.
My precious.
So, yeah. I guess I'd say I'm doing okay. I mean, it's just a thing. And I'll get one eventually. Eventually. Eventually.
And now let's get back to business.
Don't crap yourself.
Hello, boys and girls, and welcome back to Don't Craft Yourself. I'm your lovely host, Laughing Lexi. Today, we're doing a special product.
I'm going to be teaching you on how to make your very own puppet. Yay! It's very simple. All you need is a notebook, your parents' permission, tax evasion, string. Then you use your imagination and you get your own little puppet friend. Isn't that right, Mr. Puppet?
You are Brian.
He's so fun and funny. Me and Mr. Puppet can go on bike rides or maybe swimming. Or maybe we can go on a picnic. Don't you just love making friends?
My wife is such a fucking bitch.
Well, it seems Mr. Puppet has gotten his own personality.
Every woman is a lesbo now. Back in my day, I could say bitch without even having to... So many war crimes.
Crap yourself. Not fucking dead. Okay, girls and boys, sometimes your puppet just doesn't go as planned, but you can always figure out how to work out differences with your best friend.
Don't see fatties as my equal. No, I'm not gonna argue with you.
It is a red Subaru with a IR booby sticker.
He keeps talking about his military service.
Crap yourself.
You see an old lady across the street. Don't just stand there and glue your feet. You gotta go across and help her through.
Unless she's a commie, then walk her like a dog.
Don't crap yourself.
Yes, I pulled a knife on an 8-year-old.
Don't crap yourself.
2 Oggos, 1 bottle of Adderall, fully in a diaper. Oh, you bird!
Crap yourself. Crap yourself. Don't crap yourself. Crap. Don't crap yourself. Crap. Don't crap yourself.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to 2020 Fashion Review. I'm your host, former CNN correspondent Charlene Hughes, and today we're going to break down some of the hottest looks of this year. So, let's hit the ground running. Here's one of my favorite looks of this year, worn by Timothy Talamet. It looks like spreading one disease wasn't enough for Timothy. He stopped by Mercy General Hospital in Washington, D.C. this June to treat a nasty case of coronavirus. Let's break down this look. Now, I'm not normally into the baggy look, but I have to admit that Timothy pulls it off flawlessly. It's all about contrasting shapes with this look. He also coordinated all of his accessories, a personal favorite of mine. That off-white with that sky blue is a gorgeous color combo. Overall, I have to rate this look around a 7 out of 10. I love the composition, but the blood running from his nose and mouth kind of ruins it for me. It doesn't even match the rest of the outfit. Let's move on to our next look. Paul Rand did his civic duty this past November by going out to vote.
Wait, who's Paul Rand?
That's not important. Now, let's break down this look. I really want to talk about the accessories with this outfit. They are hot, hot, hot. The pepper spray on his hip, you know, for those silly little pole watchers, really adds a little bit of danger to this look. You know, danger's my middle name. Rawr. The mask with the shirt is also perfect for this outing. Who knew they made matching Antifa-style masks and shirts? You know, because of the all-black...
Cut that, Charlene. This is a family-friendly show. We don't talk about those terrorists here.
Of course. The ratings don't really matter. Let's move on to the next look. Jack Schlack was spotted at the Black Lives Matter protests earlier this year, and I have to say that he is positively glowing. I don't know if that's a side effect of the tear gas or what, but his skin is amazing. The all-black ensemble is an amazingly coordinated piece, especially if you consider how well it worked with the outfits of the undercover cops hauling him away. We can all take notes from Schlack. He does get points taken away for the actively bleeding head wound, however. I give this look a 9 out of 10. that is Fashion Review 2020. Be sure to look out for Fashion Review 2021, where we review our favorite flood-ready outfits for when Florida gets swallowed by the ocean. See you there!
Hello, Mom! It's me, your son Tanner at DePaul, who has an original iPhone! Can you come get me? I want to drop out. I just found out that it gets cold in Chicago. Why didn't anybody tell me? If only literally every single time I told people I was going to college in Chicago, the first thing they fucking said was that it gets cold up there. Why didn't anybody do that?
Hi, my name is Mo, and I currently live in the city of Chicago, and one of my favorite things to do is go around the city and find splats. So, today I will be showing you some of my favorite splats from around the city in this segment called City Splats with Mo, Splats Around the City. Some of you may be wondering, what is a splat? So I have made this helpful diagram to show you all. What is a splat? These are the differences between a drip, a smear, and a splat. Now you can see in drip and smear, they're very contained, very stagnant. Drip is more goopy, and smear, as you can see, maybe someone had a little schmutz on their shoe that they just smeared onto the sidewalk. Not much going on there, not much complexity, but as you can see in the splat, there is velocity, there was an impact, and it left a mark on our city. So that is what we are going to be looking at today. Our first splat is located at that one table at that one park where all the high schoolers go to do whippets. And my best guess as to what this splat could possibly be is A, whippet residue from those teen rascals, or B, a much yuckier guess, bird excrement. This next splat is really something big, and to even see the whole thing, we have to zoom out. And yes, this huge splat is located at the Walgreens, and I'm no architect or mathematician, but Walgreens seems pretty big. And then looking at this splat through the measurements I've devised, which is one mark equals one height of my dad's half-brother, Salvador Jr., we can see that this splat is at least 3.5 sals tall. This next tragic splat was found downtown at the crosswalk where this lady said, "Hey, little guy, can you move a little faster? I got kids to pick up." And I think this Big Mac splat is, it's a representation of man's hubris. What I imagine for this splat is it was a big man who just got his Big Mac, and he was walking, and he said, "Hey, I'm a big man. I can hold my Big Mac and work my BlackBerry phone at the same time. I'm that good." But he wasn't that good. And alas, Big Mac went splat all over the crosswalk. Very confusing shapes. You can see the boxes over here, but the rest of the burger sauces and straws are over here, meaning this fall had a lot of velocity, similar to Icarus's fall from grace. And concluding our splats, we have this one. Yeah, I think it speaks for itself. I hope you've enjoyed your City Splats tour. Have a good night.
Hi, I'm Shane. Originally, I had an idea for a blackout sketch, but I overwrote it and decided I didn't like it.
Dude,
so
you got to get out of the main room. It's like 11 a.m., dude. Chill.
All right.
On January 30th, 1961, Yogi Bear first aired in the United States, and God help the animators, they did not know what was yet to come. This clip seems harmless, right? Wrong. 1961 marked the start of the largest wave of bear maulings Yellowstone had ever seen. Tourists would get close to bears in hopes of hand-feeding them and would instead be violently attacked. To get a sense of the public health crisis, I offer several reenactments.
Daddy, I want to go to Yellowstone!
Oh, yes, I would love to go to Yellowstone!
Oh, Yellowstone! Yellowstone! I'm going to feed this bear out of my hand!
I am so sorry that your son was mauled beyond recognition in that bear attack. Now he is dead and we lay his bones to rest. We tell this to no one. Bear fact! These are all animals that would normally get attacked by bears.
Despite what you might have heard from some very creative children, there are no bear maulings going on in Yosemite. Keep coming!
I have a tiny limp from my bear attack.
Lying street urchin.
I'm going to recklessly endanger myself.
And, maybe stop watching Yogi Bear?
What? Bear fact. This is what bear poop looks like. Hard to identify the human remains.
Yogi Bear is a homosexual? Yogi Bear and all other bears are homosexuals?
It's the 1960s and we don't like them.
Yogi Bear, boo.
Stay away from me! Stay away from me, you fruity little bear! Back!
Hey, boo-boo! Wanna watch me wipe with the American flag?
Are we going? What's up? I decided to ditch my earlier idea for my project that was gonna be really funny, but it was gonna take too much time and effort. And right now I'm not doing good. So instead, I'm just gonna show you guys how much of a badass I am by jumping off of my deck. I mean, how far down do you think this is? Like 50 feet? 40? 40 feet? Hopefully my balls will break my fall. Cause they're so big. Alright, enough pussy dicking around. Let's do this. Didn't know that was there.
Alright. 1, 2, 3. Oh my God, Cammy, are you okay? Yeah, man.
Okay.
Looks really epic.
I think my arm's broken.
Oh, okay.
But my penis still works. Bottoms up, bottoms up. Oh. Ever see a cup? Got a couple bottles, but a couple ain't enough.
Nice day today, Mrs. Campbell. Wouldn't you say? It's good to get out. Get some fresh air. You know, your son wants you to be more active. It's healthy. Yeah? Keeps your brain fresh. Hello? I hate my job. Car! Oh my god! Oh god! Oh shit, I knew I should have got insurance. Oh shit.
Come with me, Mrs. Campbell. Come with me into the wilderness. There's a whole world inside there full of love and happiness. So get on up out of that wheelchair. You're a big girl now, no time to spare. Now's your chance to run since nobody's there. Come on home, Mrs. Campbell, you're not alone with me. Come on home, Mrs. Campbell, to a world where nobody can leave. I'm not gonna hurt you, no sir, I'm just a friendly leaf, you see.
My last craft is insane, and frankly, I'm scared to make it. You're going to need a toilet paper roll. Oh, wow, you're thinking, green tube? Fuck you. No. I think I will give my crazy guy two different shaped eyes to show that he's a wonky fella.
What is this craft?
You'll see, fucker. I'm taping on little bits of pipe cleaner to be nostrils. Don't you think that is funny? Now, you need tissue paper. Tear it up really nice. Now, you're going to start putting the pieces of tissue paper in here. Every day, at least 6 or 7 people come up to me and say, "Hello, are you Lila from Lila's Craft Corner? I am a tween." That is usually where they stop. Okay, everybody, time for the big reveal. Now that you've glued all your tissue paper down, you have this crazy guy. It looks like he's breathing fire. But wait for this. Fuck yeah. This one I've named Becca. We all know that at the end of Lila's Craft Corner, I like to create a little story. Even a little scene. Join me. In this scene, Brandon the turkey is offering a white lily because of the death of Becca the dragon. Do not fret, tweens. As I said earlier, everything ends. Everyone will one day die. Hearts will be broken. Friends will drift apart. Lovers will stop porking. Every day, something changes. And change can be good. Sometimes also though change can be bad. Don't do bad change, do good change. Have a great day, tweens.